Welcome back again in Latilides tutorial. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to create this editable golden 3D text effect in Adobe Illustrator. And this is the 8th video, but this time it's a little different from the previous editable vector text effect tutorial, but still with the same technique with a different style, like this. But for this tutorial I'll be quick and make it short and don't explain it in detail. If you still need an explanation then you should watch my previous videos to get a detailed explanation. You can click the link here, or then you can go to the description to get the link. So, don't skip this video and watch it to the end. You can click the subscribe button if you want to see new tutorials in the future. And without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. I have prepared a document with full HD size with 1920 by 1080 pixels, with RGB color mode. You can use other sizes but it must be in RGB color mode. Okay, here I have prepared some colors that I will use as gold color in the editable vector text effect that we will create. As you can see here, I divided these colors into four groups. The first group is the background color, and the rest is the gold color group for the text. And all these colors that I will use as material to create the gradient color as shown above. This is just a preview and I will also show you how to create a golden gradient color like this in a nutshell. By the way, you can get this color in the description. And the first step is to create a background. As usual, create a rectangle following the size of the artboard using the rectangle tool. And for this background I will give it a gradient color with the gradient color that I have made here. To give it a gradient color, just open the gradient panel in the window menu. In this gradient panel you just need to click on this gradient annotator to apply this default gradient color to the background. After that, we will change the color. After this gradient is applied to the rectangle, then change the gradient type to radial. To change the color, just click the color stop on the left, then activate the color picker below to pick a color sample from the background color palette. Next, pick a lighter blue color. While for the other color stop, you just need to click and then just pick a darker blue color. This time we don't need to re-enable the color picker. And the last thing in this gradient panel is that we just need to reduce the aspect ratio to 70%. And we're done with this background, I just need to lock it. Object menu. Lock. Selection. Now, we can move on to creating the editable golden 3D text effect. First, create the text. You can create any text. After that, adjust the size to the size of the artboard. Here I give it a size of 350 points. You can use any type of font according to your needs, but I recommend using a dynamic font like handwriting like this one. Next, we're going to give it some effects using the Appearance panel. Open the Appearance panel in the Window menu. And just look for Appearance. In this Appearance panel, double-click the character layer at the top right here, and change the fill color to none, to disable the character's default color, so that it will be easier for us to apply the effect. Click the top layer again to exit the character layer. As you can see that now this text is transparent because we have removed the default fill color. For that we need to add a new fill. Click Add New Fill. And for this first fill layer, we're going to give it the first gradient color that I've set up in this palette. So to give it a gradient color, first, select this fill layer. In this tutorial I will show you two ways to give this fill layer a gradient color. The first is the fastest way, but first we need to have a sample gradient color set up like this. And the second way is how to make a gradient color using an existing flat color like this. So let's start with the faster way, but remember, first we have to have this gradient color sample. First, select this fill layer. Then use the eyedropper tool on the toolbar. After that, choose this first golden gradient color. It's as simple as that, but remember, you have to have a sample gradient like this one. And for the second way, make sure this layer is still selected, then open the gradient panel. Click the gradient annotator to apply the gradient color to the text. First change the angle to 90 degrees. Next, in this gradient annotator we need 5 color stops with different color. And for the first step we will change the color of these 2 color stops, and then add some more color stops. Click the color stop on the left. Activate the color picker below it. Then select the first color in the first gold color palette. Then the color stop on the other side with the third color. Next, we're going to add a few more color stops between these two existing color stops. The trick is, place the cursor between these two color stops under the gradient annotator. Just click there to create a new color stop. Next, make sure the color picker is still active, and choose the second color. Next, add another color stop with the third color. And the last color stop with the second color. Then you can adjust the position of all these color stops to get the right gradient color. Just close this gradient panel and reopen the appearance panel. And we're done with this first fill layer. Next, we're going to add highlights to this text to give it a bit of a realistic feel. For that, we need a stroke. In the appearance panel we already have a default stroke, so we don't need to add a new stroke, we just use this one. But we need this stroke layer to be below the fill layer, so we just need to click and drag it below the fill layer. Next, we just give it a color. But coloring this stroke will be different from giving color the fill layer, so, first we have to add this highlight color to the swatches panel. First, close the appearance panel. Then open the swatches panel. Then select this highlight color. In the swatches panel click on new swatch button, and just click OK. And here it is the highlight color that has been added. Reopen the appearance panel. Open the swatches on this stroke layer. And here we can see the highlight color we've added, just click there. Next, increase the stroke weight to 3 points. And if we look at this text, I'll zoom in a bit to make it look clearer. We'll find that the stroke surrounds the edge of the text, and I don't want it like this. I want this stroke to only appear on the top of the text, not appear on the bottom edge, so we have to move it a little bit up. Back to the appearance panel. Make sure this stroke layer is still selected, then click Add New Effect. Distort and Transform. Transform. In this transform panel, we only change the vertical move to minus 2 pixels. And the result will look like this. The highlight is only visible on the top of the text, and not on the bottom edge. I think it's perfect. Next, we're going to add a three-dimensional effect to this text, but not a three-dimensional object effect, we're just making it look like it's three-dimensional. So, add a new fill layer just below this stroke layer. To do that, select this character layer so the new layer will be above it. Then click Add New Fill. On this new fill layer we will give it the second gold gradient color in the palette, but in a different way than the previous one, and it's a quick way. But first, you need to have this gradient sample. Open the swatches panel. Select the golden gradient sample. Click the new swatch button on the swatches panel. And here it is the gradient color that has been added to the panel. Then reopen the appearance panel. Now we just need to change the gradient color of this new fill layer by opening the swatches panel in this section. Select or click the gradient color that has just been added. As usual, we can't see the result now, because this new fill layer is still covered by the fill layer above it, but that's okay because we are going to give this new fill layer a 3D effect using the transform effect. Click Add New Effect, Distort and Transform, Transform. In the transform panel, replace the horizontal move with minus 0.4 pixels, while for the vertical move with minus 0.3 pixels. Then fill in the copies with 60. And click OK. Before I finish this tutorial I want to recommend this website if you are looking for Adobe Illustrator courses, from beginners to experts, or you can also get other creative courses, the link to this website is under the like button. Okay, back to the tutorial, actually, by using this appearance, we can give some effects to an object, or text with the advantage that we can edit the object, or text and the effect is still there. Like this editable golden 3D text effect, we can still edit the text or even change the font type, or we can still change the size. So if this tutorial was useful, please click the subscribe and like buttons. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me in the comments. See you in the next tutorial.